I gave AI my search history. Here's what it told me. Hi, everyone. Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. I was listening to a podcast earlier this week where the host took the sequence of questions he had asked AI, and I honestly don't know if he was using ChatGPT or something else, and fed those back into ChatGPT and said, hey, build a profile of the person asking these questions. And the profile was actually kind of eerily accurate. There were a lot of assumptions made about the individual, and they were more or less spot on. That got me to thinking, what about search history? It is one of the very common concerns that I hear about from readers all the time. What about my search history? Can somebody see my search history? Can I delete my search history? All that kind of stuff. My question today was, well, given my search history, what can AI tell me about myself? So, what I did is I went to Google Takeout and extracted my entire search history from the beginning, apparently. It goes back to 2006, and apparently I've searched for over 48,000 things in that time. This is searching only on Google, but as you can imagine, that's a lot. The file is over 900 megabytes in size. Now, I will say that extracting just the search terms was very difficult. It actually required a little bit of programming and regular expressions for those who know what that is. You can, of course, get your search history. That's easy. You'll get something that's displayed very easily and you can scroll through it and see it and all that. But of course, there's a lot of other information in there. I just wanted the terms. I just wanted, what did I search for in, you know, since 2006? So that required a little bit of work. Now, like I said, it was 900 megabytes, 48,000 entries. As it turns out, not only was that a lot, it was actually too much. I actually had to pare it back. So I ended up using two different AIs. The first one that I used was Claude. Claude, and the reason I used it first is because I know that it has a larger capacity. You can give it more information. As it turns out, though, it still couldn't accept all 48,000 queries. It could only take 16,000 queries, which basically for me boiled down to around the last 5 years. I gave it this prompt. I said, provide a profile for the person whose search history is as follows. And then I pasted in 16,000 search terms. The Claude generated profile is actually not that bad. Presumably, you'll see it scrolling by here on the video. You will also be able to access the full text over at the companion article for this video, askleo.com/166948. But you can see that, you know, based on the search history provided, here's a possible profile for this person. Male, likely in his 40s or 50s. Thank you. It's off, but I'm happy with it. Lives in the Seattle area, of course, works in tech, you bet, possibly as a software development or IT professional, yep. Interested in computers, technology, online security, Linux, Unix, web development, WordPress, PHP, etc. Owns an Nikon, dog owner, possibly of a Welsh Corgi, imagine that, and a bunch of other things, right? So it was actually, I would call it eerily accurate. Wasn't 100%. I wish I were still 50, but I'm not. I'm 66. The bottom line, however, is that it's actually pretty good, and that was based only on my search history. Okay, great. Claude took a bunch of information and told me something about myself. What about the one we've heard about so much, ChatGPT? Well, ChatGPT has a significantly smaller capacity. In fact, I was only able to give it 126 searches, not 16,000, which represents only about the last 6 months of my searches. Once again, I asked ChatGPT, provide a profile for the person whose search history is as follows, and I pasted in 126 search entries. It generated also a pretty reasonable profile. Again, you can see it over at askleo.com/166948. But highlights include, yeah, he's tech savvy and a problem solver, interested in geography and travel, automotive knowledge, I'll talk about that in a minute, cultural interests, healthcare awareness, food and local activities, academic inclinations, digital content creation and management, general curiosity and diverse interests. The actual text was much more detailed than the bullet list I just gave you. As you can tell, it's reasonably accurate. It actually did a pretty good job of characterizing just who I am. Again, a few things were a little bit off. For example, the automotive knowledge, that was based on my having searched for some terms related to vacuum line diameters. For those of you that aren't into automobiles, as I am not, a vacuum line is used inside many automotive engines for a variety of reasons having to do with, of course, vacuum. What's interesting about it, though, is that that's not what I was searching for. It wasn't an automotive-related application at all. Vacuum lines I knew were about the right size to fit on the perches of my bird feeder, and I just wanted to understand what the exact size was. So, a little bit of misinterpretation there, right? ChatGPT took my search for something that is usually automotive to indicate automotive interest, except it wasn't. Similarly, the academic inclination, I was just looking up a definition of adjunct professor. That's it. Does that imply an academic inclination? I don't think so. Granted, this is based on only the last 126 searches. So I give it a lot of slack for being somewhat off the mark in a few cases. But honestly, it was actually pretty good. I'm actually still fairly impressed that it was able to generate what it did with only 126 search terms. The quote that I loved was an inclination towards solving technical problems. Imagine that. So why does this matter? Why do we care? Why am I telling you about this? Well, I'm using myself as an example. Because with or without AI, your search history can reveal a lot about who you are and what you do. Normally, your search history is available only to you with a properly secured account. However, I know that many people worry about that. They worry about other people getting access to the search history. While this analysis has always been possible, AI made it so possible that it literally took maybe 30 seconds for each of these queries to both be pasted into the tool and generate its results. That's pretty amazing. Now, personally, I'm not concerned. I'm leaving my 18-year search history with Google. I don't care. I'm not that interesting. And as it turns out to be pretty useful for examples like this. However, I know that not everybody is as comfortable with that information being in the hands of Google or Bing or whomever else you happen to be using for your search engine. Therefore, knowing that this exists and knowing that this kind of analysis is possible, you now might want to make some different decisions, either about how you use the tool, which tools you use, or whether or not you need to clean up and trust that it's been cleaned up, your search history. But I personally just found this super fascinating and bodes well and interesting, again, for the future of some of the things we'll be able to do with AI. For comments, for links, for the full text of what both AI engines returned for their characterization of me, visit askleo.com/166948. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.